How's that? Is that one affecting your GI?
Oh, my GI is good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How about the donut? Is that one affecting your GI? Gio, are you okay? Gio? Gio?
What the hell is GI?
Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Diaries of the Drunken Dumbells.
Did you know that certain foods are ranked based on how they affect your blood sugar?
There are certain foods that can make your blood sugar levels shoot up very fast,
which causes you to release more insulin to bring your levels back to normal.
If this regulation process happens too often,
which happens for many of us,
it can cause a lot of problems,
such as weight gain,
cardiovascular disease,
diabetes,
high blood pressure, and way more. So a ranking system was created to determine which carbohydrates,
when digested,
have the highest impact on your blood sugar levels.
Glycemic index,
aka GI,
shows how quickly food breaks down in your bloodstream.
The measure ranks food on a scale of 0 to 100.
And a food with a high GI raises blood sugar more than a food with a medium to low GI.
Meats and fats don't have any carbohydrates, so therefore they don't raise blood sugar. These foods that rank high on the GI scale are often high in processed carbohydrates and sugars.
But not always. Pretzels, for example, have a GI of 83.
And a baked potato without the skin clocks in at a whopping 98.
Victory to the potato, yay!
Foods with a lower GI are digested at a slower rate, so they cause less of a spike in your blood sugar levels.
This equals less insulin secretion, which equals less fat storage and less potential health risk.
These foods are usually high in fiber, fat, and protein. Some examples are apples with a GI of 28,
Greek yogurt at 11, and peanuts at 7.
Whoa, hold up though. Just because it's low on the glycemic index does not necessarily mean it's high in nutrients.
You still need to choose healthy foods.
A good rule of thumb when planning your meals is to be sure that your components have a GI less than 55.
And that they are minimally processed foods. You also want to pay attention to your overall carbohydrate consumption.
Yeah, because eating like 50% of your total daily calories and carbohydrates is still going to raise your blood sugar. So even if the GI is low in some foods, it's going to be really important to look at both aspects. You want to look at the glycemic index, but also your overall carbohydrate intake. Hey, thanks again for tuning in to another episode of Diaries of the Drunken Dumbells with Di and my sidekick, G.I. or Gio.
And if you have any questions about the glycemic index, just put it in the comments below.
Or just send us a direct message if you're going to be shy about it.